Welcome back, everyone. So someone requested how to light a headlight in a car, setup scene. So today we are going to be tackling this. So here I have a basic setup here, which is a simple floor and a simple car model here and some area lights. So let me just show you my overall scene here. So this is what my scene looks like. Nothing too complex, just a simple area light. So I'm going to get rid of this area light so we can get started from the scratch. So we have no lights, nothing whatsoever. So the first thing I want to do is basically add some lights. I'm going to take an area light here, bring this light up, and let's rotate this to something like this, and let's bring this somewhat about here. Let's scale this up. Okay, so I have something like this. Let's see how that's looking. So I already have a camera set up here, but if you want, you can take another camera from Create Camera. So I have set a nice view for the overall camera here, which looks pretty good. So let's see how that's looking. So right now the overall exposure on our light is a bit too low, so I'm going to go to my area light. Let's increase the exposure to maybe like 6, and we see something. So I'm just gonna reset the whole camera again and let's make it 10. All right, so we see something from here, so let's keep it to like that. Something around 10 exposure is good, and I'm going to increase the resolution to something like 1000 and maybe samples to about 4. Let's make the samples for diffuse and speculative 2 as well, so we have a bit more good samples going on. All right, so I'm going to call this light a top light. All right, perfect. So we have a basic setup here, and from here at this point we are going to start lighting our whole scene. So the first thing that we want is, if you'll go to the overall headlights here, so I've separated the whole parts here. This is my overall front glass and this is the overall headlights that we want. So we'll see how we can shade this. So the first thing that we are going to do is, let me just open my IPR again here, and I'm gonna draw a render region around here just so we can see how this is looking. And in the outline I've already set up all the things that I need for the overall setup here. So I have a light which is the inside part here, sorry, this is my glass and this is my light. All right, so let's get started with the glass here. So I'm gonna add a new material. Let's go to shaders, stand surface, and I'm gonna call this glass. Let's make the weight to 1, and from here you can directly take a preset for this, which is a simple glass material, and you won't see anything because we don't get much light in our scene. And the next thing that you want to do is select your overall object here, which is a glass object, and make sure you turn off the opaque so the light can pass properly. All right, so once you are done that, so the next step is to lighting the overall headlights here. So I've tried a couple of methods with this. The first method that I tried was obviously the emission, which did kind of give that glowy effect, that bloomy effect that headlight has, but it was not good enough. Then I also tried the overall mesh light here, which was kind of good. So let me just show you the overall different kind of result that you can get from something that adds a bit more emission or something like that. So I'm just gonna pause this and bring this out. And let's play this again. So I'm gonna add a new material to this. This will be a simple stand surface, and I'm gonna turn everything off and add a simple emission to this. Yeah, there you go. All right, so I'm gonna go to my perspective shape here. So here you can see how the emission is looking overall, which is not exactly how we want it. I can make the emission to weight something like a 5, which is too bright, or maybe like a 10. I can change the overall color if I want. But this is still not giving the overall effect that we want. You can also try to add a bit more mesh light here, which will give you this kind of look. Increase the exposure and click on light visible, you'll have this kind of look, but exactly the same look, not exactly what we want. So to solve this, what we are going to do is we can combine multiple things here. So I'm going to go back to my camera view. So the first thing that we are going to do is go to our overall lights here, which is basically these type of object that are in front of your car, and we are going to add a new material to this, and you can turn on the shading from here, so just so you don't see the glass material overall, or you can select it from outline as well and right click, add a new material, go to normal stand surface, and let's call this light. That's it. And I'm gonna turn on my IPR again just so we can see what's going on, and let's turn this on. Let's select this region around here, and I'm going to make the emission to something like maybe one. So now you can see the overall headlights here, which is not too strong, not too light, too bright or something like that, which is just perfect. You can increase the value if you want. You can make the overall emission weight to something like a 2 if you want a bit more bright, but I think 1 is good enough. Let's keep it to 2 for now and we are good to go. All right, so we have something like this, but the overall look is not exactly how we wanted. We don't see anything going on with the overall lighting effect. So the next thing that we are going to add is a simple area light, which is going to sell the whole effect. So if I take a area light, let me just go to my light here, and this is my light. So the light is facing on the opposite direction, so I'm gonna hit G on my keyboard and just rotate this to something about here. Perfect. So I'm gonna align my area light right about where my headlights are. So let's scale this down and let's scale this up right about there. So it just fit as much as you can. It shouldn't be like, it doesn't have to be a perfect light aligned, perfectly aligned, but good enough. All right, so I'm gonna duplicate this, Control D, move this right about there as well. So we have both our headlights, looks perfect. Right about there, I'm gonna select this one. And move it right about there. Okay, so I think the overall light is looking good. Okay, so let's go back to our IPR to see how this is looking, and I'm gonna select both of my area lights here and I'm gonna make the exposure to something like a 4. Alright, so we can see the overall light is passing through and we can see the overall lighting here. We can increase more exposure if we want. So you can see the overall effects here. So I'm gonna keep this to something like a 4 here, and let's increase the resolution and add a bit more sample into this. Okay. So we have area light, we have good lighting going on, still we don't see much of an effect going on around here. So how do we fix that? So to fix that, we have to add a bit of atmosphere to this. So I'm going to go to my render settings here and go to environment and add atmosphere. Okay, so let's turn on our IPR and I'm going to make the density, by default the density has been set to 0, so I'm going to make this 0.1. Instantly everything kind of blows up because we have too much exposure in our scene. So the first thing that we have to do is go to our top light and reduce the exposure to something like maybe a reasonable amount, to maybe like a 6 or maybe like a 4. So I think 6 is kind of a good enough number for me. This is looking quite good. And the one thing that we have to reduce is the overall effect on this light. If you'll notice here, we can see the overall light passing through, which is kind of giving us the overall result here, but the other light is not exactly passing through. So that means it is kind of intersecting somewhere. So I'm just gonna bring this out a bit. All right, select this light. Which one was it? Yeah, and bring this out until I see the overall light passing through. And we don't have enough exposure in this, I guess that's why the overall result. Yeah, so the one light has been set to the exposure 4, so now I'm going to set the exposure 4. So now you have this kind of effect, which is good enough, I guess, in a way, but not exactly what we are going for. We have too much volumetrics going on and not exactly what we are looking for. So the way we are going to fix this is, the first thing I'm going to change is obviously my top light, because it's kind of too bright. So I'm just going to scale this down a bit and also add a bit more roundness and rotation, just so it doesn't have a very sharp cons going on. All right, so let's go back to our main thing, which is our headlights. So I'm going to select my first area light, and the way we are going to control this is, let me just stop this. All right, so this is our light, and if you'll notice closely here around this part, let me just close my outliner, and right about here, the overall volumetrics, it's kind of spreading all the way, like or something like a uniform or a radial effect. So I'm gonna just add a render region here, and from my outliner here, I think it was this light. Yeah, so let's see, I'm gonna change the one thing, which is kind of the spread, which is going to be selling the whole effect. So if I reduce this, you'll notice that the light gets sharper and sharper. So the way you have designed your light, it's going to emit that kind of light. So we don't have any spreadness going on. Obviously, we don't want this kind of effect. So we are going to add a bit more spreadness to this, to maybe like something like a 0.2. So this is what we get now. Instead of this, we have a bit more sharp, like a headlight should be. So I'm going to do the same with the overall area light of the other one as well, headlight. So now we have a bit more brighter scene. So I'm just going to decrease the exposure to maybe something like a 2 for both of these lights. And from the emission here, so I'm just gonna go to my light material here. I think the emission is a bit too much. We don't need that much emission. I'm gonna make the weight to 1. Let's hit play. All right, so this looks pretty good. I'm gonna do the same with my top light. Let's remove the render region. Anil is kind of consuming too much power on this. I don't know why. This is a simple scene. But anyways, so I'm gonna go to my top light and reduce the split to something like 0.5. And I think this is good enough. So you can also control one thing, which is the samples on your volume. If you don't want that much volume in your scene, what you can do is you can reduce the amount of volume you have by simply decreasing the volume samples. So you can do that as well. So now the overall effect looks pretty good. I'm just gonna add a little bit of blue tint from my top light here, just a little bit, and I can do the same with the other lights as well. If you want, you can add this as well to your lights. Just a little bit of bluey tint looks pretty good. Alright, so I'm gonna close this and let's hit play. And from here I can go to my perspective view here, and from here you can see how this is looking. I'm just gonna quickly switch to the GPU version of my render engine. Alright, so I've switched my device from CPU to GPU. That's why it was so laggy, because it was running on CPU. Alright, so from here let's see our overall scene here. So alright, so this is our scene, looks pretty good. And you can pretty much move around in your scene, and you can see how this is kind of the overall, your headlights are affecting the overall environment here. You can add a bit more light in your tail light as well to give that kind of effect. So you have a pretty interesting lighting setup going on, and this is how you can light the overall headlight effect in your car scene. One thing, if you are animating your car and if you have a running scene or driving scene, what you can do where your car is kind of in a moving position, what you can do is you can simply select the overall light here, and you can simply select your car and simply hit P on your keyboard, and that will just parent that light to your car. So if I move my car here, you'll notice that the overall area light is moving with it. Let me just turn this on, and yeah. So here you'll notice the light has been moved as well. So wherever I move my car, the light will move as well. All right, so that was a bit more laggy for some reason. Let me just go back. All right, so I've parented both of my lights to my car here. So if I move this up now and update the full scene here, you'll notice that my lights are moving with my car. So IPR does have some problem moving around the whole light. But yeah, so wherever you move your car from here, at this point the lights will be completely attached to your scene here. So you can move wherever your car you want and the light will be attached. So simply hit on your, simply select your light, select your car, hit P on your keyboard, and that will just parent the whole thing, and that's it. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. It was really fun to make, really cinematic look, really amazing look. So thank you for the request, and I hope this helps your cause or whatever project you're working on. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.